Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Bulfet. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace the Speaker of the Representatives Council, Ahmed bin Ibrahim Al Mulla, the Chairman of the Shura Council, Ali bin Saleh Al Saleh, their deputies, and the Chairman of the Council's Committee on the occasion of approving the Unified Family Law. Present were His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander, and First Deputy Premier, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Majesty expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince for the constant cooperation between the executive and legislative authorities, which contribute to making more achievements for the kingdom and its people. His Majesty also expressed thanks to the Speaker, Chairman, and members of the two councils for their efforts in adopting and completing the family law. He hailed the competency of the legislative authorities' members. The law derives its necessity from the needs of the family and the requirements of society. His Majesty the King expressed thanks to President of the Supreme Council of Islamic Affairs, Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalid Al Khalifa, for his efforts, and to the members of the Sharia Committee to review the draft family law, as well as the Legislation and Legal Opinion Commission, for their exerted efforts, which shed a light on the size of commonalities between Islamic doctrines. This law represents a basic requirement for enhancing the efficiency of the judiciary, establishing the guarantees of protecting the rights of litigants, and maintaining the cohesion of the Bahraini family. His Majesty the King also expressed pride in the issuance of the family law, affirming that it is an accomplishment added to Bahrain's comprehensive development and to its legal system that protects the family entity, and also a source of pride to all Bahrainis, which strengthens the high position of Bahrain and its leading role among developed and civilized countries. He also praised the efforts of the Supreme Council for Women and its support of the issuance of the Unified Family Law, which will contribute to the stability of the Bahraini family and women, as well as reinforce its status in society. His Majesty added that the decree to form the Sharia Committee to study family law, review its provisions, and ascertain their conformity with the provisions of Islamic law came to embody His Majesty's keenness on ensuring that the law conforms with the provisions of Islamic Sharia, and that Bahrain will remain a supporter for freedoms and the rights of its people. His Majesty hailed the role of the legislative authority in serving the developmental march, protecting national causes, and developing laws and legislations that ensure Bahrain's identity as a country of law and organizations. The Representatives Council Speaker, Shura Council Chairman, their deputies, and the Chairman of the Council's committees expressed thanks and gratitude for His Majesty's role and support for the law, wishing His Majesty success in leading the country to further development and prosperity. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa issued Royal Order 40 of 2017 stipulating dissolving the third session of the fourth legislative term of the Shura and Representatives Council starting July 20, 2017. First Deputy President of the Supreme Council for Youth, President of the Bahrain Athletics Association, and Honorary President of Bahrain Disabled Sports Federation, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, directed the High Committee organizing the fifth edition of the Khalid bin Hamad for Youth Centers to include and approve those clubs that are not under Bahrain Football Association in this edition of the league. The league is part of His Highness's supporting and humanitarian initiative under the slogan Meeting of Generations. The event will be organized by the Ministry of Youth and Sports Affairs in collaboration with His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa Media Center. The draw of the Futsal Youth Centers, People with Disabilities and Girls League in its fifth edition was held yesterday at the Bahrain Authority for Tourism and Exhibitions Hall of 2030 Youth City. His Highness stressed on the importance of allowing clubs and girls to participate in this league. He said that the league's fifth edition coincides with the vision of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sport, chaired by the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Works and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and the necessity in activating the role of the youth centers, since it is considered to foster Bahraini youths and a place where the league gathers within the framework of supporting and strengthening programs to their abilities. His Highness Sheikh Khalid expressed appreciation for the efforts made by the Minister of Youth and Sports Affairs, Hisham bin Mohammed Al-Joder, to launch the fifth edition of the league, stressing the prominent role of the representatives of the ministry in the establishment of the league. Sheikh Khalid praised the active participation of the youth centers, as this year's league includes 36 youth centers from different governorates of the kingdom, 9 national clubs, 8 people with disabilities team, and 6 girls teams. The High Organizing Committee of the Futsal Khalid bin Hamad League for Youth Centers, People with Disabilities and Girls has approved the registration of 9 unregistered clubs in the current league, raising the number of participating teams to 45 in the league this year. The Shura Council held an extraordinary session today headed by its chairman Ali bin Saleh Al Saleh, in which they unanimously approved issuing the family law according to the report submitted by the Council's Legislative and Legal Affairs Committee. The Minister of Parliament Affairs, Ghanem bin Fadl Al Bahinin, expressed thanks and appreciation to the Shura Council members for their role in crafting and issuing legislations and laws, hailing the cooperation between the Shura Council's municipality and the Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs.
A very good evening. You're watching the Business News in Bahrain International with me, Hiba Abdul Ghaffar. Bahrain Oil Share Index closed today at 1,319.03 points, marking an increase of 4.09 points above the previous closing. The increase was due to the rise in the industrial and commercial bank sector, and investors mainly traded in the commercial bank sector, representing 43% of the total value of traded shares. 96 equity transactions took place, with a volume of 3,947,401 worth 1,032,031 Bahraini dinars.